The negotiations of the EU Cyber Resilience Act have concluded after the EU Parliament approved it earlier this year. The Council of the EU followed up with its approval in October. The Act is expected to take effect in the fall of 2024, with full compliance required within 36 months after that. We sat down with President and CEO of KDAB, Kalle Dalheimer, to discuss further. What does the CRA mean for KDAB?
The CRA is going to mean several things for KDAB, but all in all, we think it's good news because it means that there will need to be a much greater emphasis on software quality. Software quality has been a top focus for us at KDAB from day one, not just because we think it's good business, but also because it's a much more rewarding way for our dedicated engineers to develop software that actually has very high quality than just quickly put something bad together. Traditionally, many buyers have bought the cheapest possible option and then got some cheaply and quickly cobbled together software, which had all kinds of security holes. And our industry is riddled with software that has been thrown together by the cheapest bidder. A lot of that will simply not be good business anymore in the future. Even though we've been focusing on top quality software, we will also need to change a few things. For example, while cybersecurity has always been in the back of our minds, and we certainly have not produced any gaping security holes, it is something that will come to the front of our thinking and planning in the future. Something that we do a lot at KDAB and that's going to be important for any software vendor is documented code reviews, because that's one of the ways where you can actually comply with the requirements of documenting how you are achieving resilient software without any gaping security holes.
Some people have feared that the CRA will hamper open source development in Europe.
Indeed, the first drafts were written with complete disregard of the realities of open source development. But then there were consultation rounds and open source advocacy organizations like the Open Source Initiatives and others have submitted their concerns. And in the draft from December 2023, many of these concerns were actually met, so that open source developers themselves will not be liable if somebody just downloads their software and puts it into their product. It's interesting and remarkable that companies that use open software, usually for free because they just download it or they have it with their distribution or get it packaged somewhere from a hardware vendor maybe, that they will now have liability to ensure that they're actually using the latest versions. If you didn't know about a security hole and you couldn't have known it because nobody knew about it yet, then there is no liability. But if there was a security hole and a newer version of the software had plugged the hole and you have not updated the devices that you have shipped, then you become liable. That means, of course, that there will need to be update mechanisms in many, many devices. And while maybe the firmware on your home router already has an update mechanism, but does your smart light bulb have an update mechanism? Probably not. Some do. I'm aware of some that do. But in general, I don't think that's the case. There's also, if we're looking a bit further into the future, the platforms that currently distribute open software, the distributed repositories, I'm thinking of GitHub or GitLab or Bitbucket or others, they might take a stance themselves as well, even though they themselves are not actors in the sense of the CRA. But it's very possible that a site like GitHub, for example, will put up automatic banners, warning banners on a project that hasn't seen any maintenance for a certain amount of time. So right now, you will have to look for yourself. It's a common question if you're looking for an open source project that you can integrate into your software, and a common question is this still maintained? Is somebody actively working on this? If any security flaws become known, is there somebody who will actually fix them? Of course, it's open source. You can always fix them yourself. But then part of the advantage of using that open source software, of course, disappears. So the power of the many eyeballs if it's just you doing it. So it might be that the culture around open source is going to change, not in the next couple of months or in the next year, but over time. For example, in the software industry, we have a saying of dumping something on GitHub. Basically, we have a body of software that we don't plan to make any money off anymore or not at all. And we want to make it available to the world, or we just want to show it off. So we put it on GitHub and then we forget it there. That is a very common thing to do for many software projects. It's possible that this will be considered antisocial behavior in the future, that you should only put on those software distribution platforms projects that you intend to maintain. And when you don't intend to maintain them anymore, it might be that social contracts would require you to remove those projects. Again, this is all just speculation on my part, but this is something that I could very well see happening.